innovation is in guidance, and emblem is guidance is in the hand of fire. عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أو كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا رأى ما يحب قال الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات. And the authority of Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he would see something that he would like, he would say, Alhamdulillah, alladhi bi ni'matihi tatimmu as-salihat. The praise is to Allah by whose grace good deeds are completed. قَدْ أَرَانَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مَا يُحِبُّ هَا أَنْتُمْ فِي مَسْجِدِكُمْ الذي انتظرتموه طويلا فاللهم لك الحمد انت وحدك المنعم انت وحدك المتفضل انت الكريم. As for this hadith, whenever the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would see something he liked, he would say praises to Allah by whose grace good deeds are completed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us, is shown us right now what we like. This is your masjid, the one that you waited for a long time. So we say, Allahumma laka alhamd, we praise Allah azza wa jal for this ni'mah. Allah azza wa jal, the bestower of blessings and mercy. عباد الله ثمار الصبر لا بد وان تجمع. The fruits of patience, even for a long time, you will get it. صبرتم فنلتم وانفقتم في سبيل الله عز وجل فوفاكم الله عز وجل في هذه الدنيا. You are patient and you're getting the fruits of your patience. You spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and here's the promise of Allah azza wa jalla came true. فما بالك لمن صبر على الهموم والاحزان وما يسوءه في هذه الدنيا ابتغاء الاخره. فما بالك من انفق في سبيل الله عز وجل أجرهم في الآخرة. So let us make a small comparison. If we spend for the sake of Allah and we work patience, and we see the reward here, how about the reward in the hereafter and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us. نسأل الله العظيم كما وفقنا في هذه الدنيا وجمعنا في بيت من بيوته على طاعته أن يجمعنا في الجنة. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He gave us the tawfiq to build this masjid and to sit and to listen for Allah's guidance and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we're sitting these sittings and gatherings pleasing Allah, that we sit and we gather in the gatherings and sittings of Jannah of Paradise. Ameen. أيها المسلمون كما تعلمون لقد أخذ هذا البناء مدة طويلة حتى اكتمل. This building, this center, took a long time until الحمد لله finished, more than 3 years. وجمعت له أموال وبذلت فيه تضحيات. We've collected thousands of dollars, hundreds of thousands of dollars. A lot of people sacrifice the most valuable things that they have for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. فالله أسأل أن يخلف عليكم خيرا في المال والأهل والمعافاة. To compensate you for that. To come compensate you for that and bless your wealth, your health, and your families. كل من أنفق في هذا الوحيد واستثمر ماله عند الله عز وجل ولو بالقليل ولو لم يستثمر في شيء وإنما دعا لنا ولجاري الله الغيب فالله عز وجل يجزيه خيرا. All those brothers and sisters, the one who spent for the sake of Allah in this masjid, the one who invests their wealth for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, for the hereafter, for those brothers that their intention were to give and they don't have what to give, but they make dua for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for that. أيها الأخوة تقدموا للإعلام وافتحوا المجال لإخوانكم في الحلقة. Brothers, move forward as much as you can. أيها المسلمون, we have enough another room in the back, inshaAllah, like us from the system. عندنا غرفة إضافية في الخلف وكذلك لإخوة الأخوات هنا على اليمين. أيها المسلمون, وإن كان تقريبا انتهينا من بناء المسجد إلا أننا لم ننتهي ولم ننتهي ولم نتوقف من بنائه داخليا. Brothers and sisters, even though we are almost done, finished of building the masjid, but we are not done. And we will not be done of building it from inside. إحياؤه to revive it. وأن نكون عونا في أداء رسالته and to be part of delivering the message of the masjid in the community. وأن نساعد هذا المسجد بردم خدماته لحفظ الجارية ولسلامة الجارية ولسعادة الجارية ولتقريب الجارية من الله تبارك وتعالى. To be part, to help, to aid, to assist this masjid, to serve as a center, as a masjid, to help the community, to help the community, to preserve our children, to preserve the young generation. فالآن بدأ العمل. As for now, now we can say that we're gonna stop working. يقول الله تعالى في بناء المساجد ودور المساجد في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بين عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran about the role, the job of the masjid in the society, in the community. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in mosques, houses of Allah, which Allah has ordered to be raised, to be cleaned, to be honored, and then His name is glorified in the morning and in the afternoon or the evening. Men, so Allah is describing the men of the masjid, men who neither trade nor sail, divert them from the remembrance of Allah with heart and tongue, nor from performing as-salah, nor from giving as-zakah. وانطلاقا من هذه الآية الكريمة على الجميع, على الجميع أن يشارك في تحقيق هذا الهدف عبادة الله عز وجل والدعوة إلى دينه وأن نكون عاماً لبعض من بعض ولن نحقق هذه الأهداف إلا إذا عرفنا وتذكرنا من نحن في هذا المسجد. So brothers and sisters, with the guidance of these verses from Surah Al-Nur, all of us, it is a command upon all of us to be part of and to participate to fulfill this goal, this purpose, ibadatullah, worship Allah, and to call for the deen, the religion of Allah, and to help and assist one another to fulfill this goal. And we will not be able to fulfill this goal unless we would remember and recognize ourselves who we are in this masjid. ففي نحن هذا في هذا المسجد نحن بذات مسلمون نتبع القرآن والسنة بفهم سلفنا الصالح النهج الطويل والصراط المستقيم قد عافانا الله تبارك وتعالى مما ابتلى به الآخرين من التحزب والجماعات فالحزبية والتحزب والتفرق منقوض عند الله تبارك وتعالى يبغضها الله عز وجل ويبغضها رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وكم جرى التفرق والتحزب والتشرذم كم جرى من الجرائم ولا يزال حتى ساعتنا هذه كم جرى على هذه الأمة من فتن وبلايا وسفك دماء فنحن جماعة واحدة وهذا المسجد قائم على الكتاب والسنة بتوحيد الله تبارك وتعالى. Brothers and sisters, the first thing to mention, who we are in this masjid. We are Muslims following the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. With the understanding of his companions and the righteous predecessors. This is the straight path. This is the path, the correct path that leads بإذن الله to جنة الفردوس. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored us and enriched us of what He tested others with. Of Hizbiya, of the groupism and sectism. Hizbiya and groupism has no place in our masjid. Disputing and splitting has no place in our masjid and in our community. Such characters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislike such characters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is like, and we're seeing other communities around us and countries. What groupism has caused for them? What sectism, being sects, has caused for them? Disaster and crimes and cursing, animosity and bloodshedding. So we are in this masjid one jama'ah. And this masjid, inshaAllah, by the word of Allah, is established and was established and will continue to be upon the Quran and the Sunnah. لقد حذر الله تبارك وتعالى من التنازع لأنه يؤدي إلى الفشل وذهاب القوة التي هي مطلب من مطالب الدين. الله سبحانه وتعالى warned us in the Quran of disputing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us in the Quran of splitting. Because that will cause us to become weak. And to be strong is one of the necessities in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله تبارك وتعالى ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we obey Allah and His Messenger. Do not dispute with one another, lest you lose courage and your strength depart. فما كان هناك نزاع الا كان معه الفشل. So then you see dispute, you see along with it failing. وما كان هناك فشل الا كان معه ذهاب الريح, اي ذهاب القوه. And whenever we have failed, there is no unity, there is weakness. والسعيد من وعظ بغيره. And the happy person is the one who takes lessons and heed and admonitions from what's going on around. فاللهم قنا شر انفسنا. We ask refuge in Allah, and we ask Allah to protect us from the evil of ourselves. نحن جارية متعددة الأطياف. What in my first community? عرب وغير عرب, عرب من عرب, حتى العرب متعددوا الأطياف. Even Arabs, they are diverse. وحتى غير العرب من المسلم, they're diverse as well. ولكن الذي يجمعنا كتاب الله عز وجل وسنة رسوله وعقيدة التوحيد ومبادئ وأسس. So what unites us in this room all together is this aqidah of tawheed, the oneness of Allah, this book of Allah, the sunnah of Rasulullah, some fundamentals and basics in the deen of Allah. فاتقوا الله في هذه الجارية. So fear Allah in your community and fear Allah in your masjid. وفي هذا المركز في هذه الجارية أطفال المسلمين. And the children of the community. دعونا نواجه التحديات والشرور المحيطة بنا كمسلمين, المحيطة بنا ونحن قلب واحد ويد واحدة. ليس لدينا مكان لفتان ولا هدام. ليس عندنا مكان للعنصرية ولا دعوة جاهلية. ونحن نقرأ كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So brothers and sisters, let us face the difficulties we face as Muslims. Let us face these challenges that is threatening us as Muslims, and we are one heart. We're united. We don't have a place for fitan. We don't have a place for someone who is trying to ruin the community and the masjid. We don't have a place here for racism. We don't have a place here for the call of the before Islam, da'wah jahiliyyah. And we have the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. من أولوياتنا الحرص على الأولاد, الجيل القادم بالتعليم الديني والتربية الدينية السليمة على الفضيلة والأخلاق الحميدة. لقد عانينا في المبنى القديم من كثرة الطلاب وعدم وجود الفصول الدراسية, وقد حان الأوان لعهد جديد ونظام جديد لهؤلاء الأطفال, وذلك يستوجب تعاون الآباء مع المسجد والمدرسة. وبإذن الله تبارك وتعالى لن نتوانى عن تقديم ما بوسعنا من المساعدة والمعونة, وهي الفصول الدراسية تحتاج التجهيز والأثاث مستلزمات التعليم لأولادكم لطلابنا. One of our things that we care about is our children, the future generation of this masjid, to raise them Islamically, to nurture them with fadila, with honor, with akhlaq, with manners, and with morals. And we have suffered a lot as we all know in the old masjid and with the old facility. There is no enough room for everybody. There is no enough classes. for our children. And here we are in this masjid, بإذن الله عز وجل, a new time with a new generation, meeting inshallah the high standards for success. And this is the rooms and the classrooms of all our masjid, the first floor and the second floor. That we need inshallah to buy the necessary materials for the school, to start the school soon inshallah. And we will not hesitate. And we will not lag inshallah. And we will not ignore any young brother and sister, those children that we care so much about, to welcome them here and to listen to them and to solve their problems and to be to them, all of us, their parents, their fathers, their mothers, and their younger, their older brothers and sisters. أقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لمن تبسط المسلمين في الدنيا استغفرهم الله الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد إخواني الكرام يقول الله تبارك وتعالى وما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه الله سبحانه وتعالى زاد القرآن فقد يستنفق سيف الله الله will compensate it. Allah will bring it back. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من بنى مسجدا لله ولو كفح سقطاه أي عش الطائر الصغير بنى الله له به بيتا في الجنة. And also the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said whoever built for the sake of Allah عز وجل a masjid as small as a bird's nest Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build him for a house in Jannah in paradise. إخواني الكرام هذا المبنى الكبير العظيم بأهله إن شاء الله تعالى مصاريفه الشهرية ليس كمن كان في المسجد القديم تكثر المصاريف مع الكهرباء والصفوف الدراسية والمصحف الكهربائي إلى آخره. So brothers and sisters, this masjid and the monthly fees and bills that we have to pay to keep running it, it's a huge lot of classrooms, elevator. Alhamdulillah, we run by the solar energy. But inshallah, there is a lot of expenses that we have to meet by the end of the month. And it's no more like living in this 150 or 120 capacity masjid, the one in the front. So what do we have to think of, inshallah? What we need to think of right now is each person amongst you, as we have a plan, as you have your insurance debt, as you have the retirement saving, as you have savings for other things, now you have to add one more item to your list, which is this masjid. Out of your income monthly, inshallah, we're going to run this soon, you have to pledge an amount. $200, $300, $500. If you can do more, Allah will give more. Monthly, it will be, inshallah, all paid, deducted for your accounts. You're not alone in this masjid. And you don't do only for yourself. And you don't do only for your family. But as I said, we do for our younger generation. Me and you. Me and you, maybe next year or another 10 years, will not be here. Will not be here. And who's going to be here? Our younger generation. They're the one who will be leading. So we better make things easy for them
so that they can continue inshallah this message, this da'wah.
ماذا يتطلب هذا المسجد؟ يتطلب مني ومنك. كما أن كل آخر شهر عندك حسابات، دفعك البيت ودفعك السيارة ودفعك التأمين ودفعك الكهرباء ودفعك الغاز، عليك أن تزيد كذلك دفعك المسجد. لابد أن أساهم بمال المسجد، مبلغ يؤخذ، مبلغ يؤخذ من حسابك البنكي كل شهر. قيمة معينة هي 300 دولار، لو اجتمع لدينا 10 20 30 40 أخ أو أخت، الحمد لله المصاريف كلها قد دفعت. So if we can get 30, 40, 50 brothers, inshallah, عز وجل will keep this all paid. الحمد لله by the end of the month, all these expenses will be paid. So inshallah, we'll talk about that more in this coming khutbah. But if you are one of those brothers, come talk to me, inshallah, so that we can set the plan. إخواني الكرام، ومن هذا المكان نريد أن نشكر ونتوجه إلى الله عز وجل بالدعاء لإخواننا كبار السن، كبار هذه الجالية، الذين كانوا اللبنة الأولى لتأسيس هذا الصرح العظيم. منهم من قضى نحبه، ومنهم ما زال معنا هنا. Brothers and sisters, if we forget something, we're not going to forget those brothers, our elders. Our elders of the community here of the masjid. The one who, because of them, and because of their sacrifices, we exist here in Manasa. Some of them already passed away, and they were dreaming and wishing to be with us today. So we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla for those who are dead amongst them to show His mercy upon them and to forgive them and to widen their graves. And for those amongst them who are alive, we ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to bless them for the rest of their life and to reward them as what they did to this community and this masjid. كذلك لا بد أن نشكر أعضاءه هذا المسجد وأمير هذا المسجد. We would like also to thank the board members of the masjid and the Amir of the masjid, the one who did and did and did. I'm not here to explain and tell you who's Dr. Hussein. We want him all. And I would like to keep it between him and Allah Azza wa Jalla. And the other brothers who gave for the sake of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala without being afraid of getting poor, or without being afraid that I'm going to run out of money to pay my bills. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them all. May Allah reward you for your patience. And inshallah, this coming future for this community will be a bright future, because this is just only the beginning, as I said. أسأل الله العليم بأسمائه الحسنى وصفاته العليا بأن لا يدعنا في مقامنا هذا إلا رفعه، الله لا تدعنا في مقامنا هذا إلا رفعه، ولا هم إلا فرشته، ولا كرب إلا فسته، ولا دين إلا قضيته، ولا مريض إلا شفيته، ولا ضال إلا هديته، ولا بيت إلا رحمته. اللهم يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم احفظ لهذه الجالية رجالها ونساءها وأطفالها، اللهم احفظنا للإسلام قائمين، واحفظنا للإسلام قاعدين، واحفظنا للإسلام راقدين. اللهم من أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بخير فارزقه إلى كل خير، من أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بشر فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر يا رب العالمين. اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم ردنا والمسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا، اللهم ردنا والمسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. إخواني الكرام، brothers and sisters,
as an advice. During the Jum'ah, you cannot answer your phones. You cannot text anyone. You cannot sit down and video the khutbah because you are actually causing harm to yourself. And you're preventing yourself from the ajr, from the reward of the Jum'ah. Right? Everybody knows on Facebook. We have Facebook inshallah. We have this camera on Facebook. If you log into the message on Facebook, you will have it. And you can make share and correct it from wrong after wrong. We have a YouTube channel, Islamic Center of Modesto, and you will see the khutbah there on YouTube inshallah. Jazakallah khairan. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa alayhi wa sallam. Wa alayhi wa sallam.